Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Savitri from All Things Beautiful. Today I'm going to show you a very colorful but very simple project. We are going to make a clock. So this is the clock base that I have taken. It's a MDF base, around 9 inches in circumference and around 5 mm thickness. So what I have done, if you look closely, I have drawn some lines and divided the board into different sections. So now I'm just going to put a masking tape in few of those sections, and I will soon show you what I'm going to do there. So I'm just cutting strips of masking tape here, and I'm covering the sides of few of my sections here. So I'm going to be doing some texturing work in these sections, so I don't want the texture to come on the other part of the section. So hence I'm masking it, masking all the sides so that my texture paste does not come out. Now I am just choosing some stencils here. I want some nice contemporary kind of design, so I'm choosing few stencils to put in these sections that I have just divided. I know I have a lot of stencils, but I still keep buying so many. I just love to do stencil work. So this is the first design that I've chosen. I am just going to simply take a texture paste. This texture paste is from Itsy Bitsy, but you can make your own texture paste. You can check my other video where I have shown how to make a gesso. Texture paste is just a thicker version of gesso. So just apply your texture paste with a palette knife in one section of the clock. Here I have divided this section, and I am going to completely texture this whole vertical section with this stencil. I'm choosing another design for the other part now. It's a very beautiful flowers bunched rose design that's going to look really beautiful when we stencil. I just love stenciling, guys, for a couple of reasons. One is, it's so satisfying to just smother that creamy paste onto the stencil, and then when you remove the stencil, the design just comes out so beautifully. I just love to do that and see that. And the second thing is, any project you take, when you do some little bit of stenciling here and there, it just brings together the whole project so beautifully. It actually gives a very different beauty and appearance to the project. So I just love stenciling. So yeah, once the stencil is dried completely, it will take like maximum an hour, but you can also air, use a hair dryer and dry it. And I'm removing the masking tape. See, in spite of masking tape, I have just put some of the texture paste onto the board here. That's fine, we're going to paint it. So I'm just scraping off the excess with some sandpaper and just wiping it off. So now I have given some stenciling in two sections of this board, The other sections, what we will do is we will just paint them with different colors, some nice complementing colors, and just paint these divisions that I've made on the board. Each section we will do it with a different paint. I'm using chalk paints here. These are from iCraft and they are just wonderful chalk paints, very creamy, and their coverage is very good. So if you would like, you can just buy it from their website. So now I'll just choose different colors, complementing colors, and I'm going to go ahead and just paint all the sections. I'm giving the same shade in two sections, so it the board will have some kind of symmetry to it. So yeah, I mean, there is no hard and fast rule as to how you have to paint it, or you have to paint it the same way that I am doing it here. It's completely up to your choice and up to your imagination and creativity. You can just color them however you want. Even the texturing, you can do it in any pattern that you want. Even the patterns you can draw in any way that you want. I have done vertical sections here. You can do horizontal sections as well. So that's completely up to you. It's up to your imagination and up to your creativity. This is just some kind of technique that you can use to create a lot of different projects. I would like to give this a vintage look, so there's a very, very easy technique to do that. What you do is take some brown color, water it down nicely. Don't take the thick color. Even if you're using acrylic paints, don't use the thick paint. Water it down, add water and make it runny and thin. And then you take a brush and paint the edges or wherever you want the antique distressed look to be seen. And immediately blend it along with the other color or along the project. You have to do it immediately, because if the paint dries, then you will not be able to rub it off. You won't get the vintage effect. So what you do is water the brown color and apply the brown color wherever you want the vintage look, and just blend it or just smudge it, smudge the color with your brush. If there's excess, you can just take a sponge or a cloth and dab it out. So that will give you this vintage look and not those bright colors that we've painted. You can actually see the vintage distressed look around the edges of all the sections. And for the texturing part, I am just giving them a gold enhanced look. So I'm taking some gold metallic color on a stencil brush, just a little bit of color, not too much, and just dry brush them over the stencil. So this will give it a very good effect. The same thing I will do it on the rose as well. So now I think what I will do is it looks a little plain, so I want to do some more stenciling. So I have chosen this design. What I'm thinking is I will just do this design like half and half in between the two sections. So I have chosen a cream color here, and I'm going to stencil this design right down the middle of my clock. And to fill up a few other places, just to give it some highlight, I am choosing another stencil here, and I'm taking gold again and stenciling that flower onto that that patch. And again, I'm stenciling different sections with different designs. So you can do the same, use different stencils, maybe even writings and scripts or whatever you have, and just give the whole board a nice look with different textures and colors and stencil. The center part looks a little bold to me, the cream color, so I want to kind of sober it down. So I have used some gold and just stenciled one half of the design in gold. I think this looks much better now. And I'm going ahead and stenciling the other sections also with different designs. And now to finish it off, what I'm doing here is just stenciling some nice motivational or inspirational words onto that part. And yeah, that's our completed project. Give it a nice couple of coat of varnish and your and fix the clock machine, and your clock is ready. Absolutely beautiful, and a very simple technique as well. So if you liked this video, please do subscribe and hit the like button. And yes, please do subscribe and support me. Follow me on Facebook and Instagram too. Thank you so much, and happy crafting. Bye bye.